All right, guys, we're gonna take off here. We gotta go down and meet a contractor and check out a new fire job. This is a new contractor that we're doing some work for. So pretty excited to meet him. Seems like a good guy, but we'll find out. They all seem good at first, you know, but anymore, I tell you what, we're
2 minutes.
We're so busy last few years that honestly, we try to partner ourselves up with good contractors. They're not all good, and I know this sounds arrogant, but we don't want to be involved with them if they're not, because you know our name is associated. So if the jobs are bad, customers are always mad. We'll actually turn contractors down. That's one of the benefits of being a small owner of a plumbing business, is you're always in demand. You don't need a whole lot of work to keep you busy, so you can pick and choose the contractors that you want to associate yourself with. I feel that pretty much everybody we're working with right now is fantastic. Everybody's struggling a little bit, you know, trying to find good help, trying to get material. Jobs are taking longer, so there are some customers that, you know, unfortunately are unhappy, and it is what it is. I don't blame them, but it's not always the contractor's fault. It's not always our fault. We're doing our best, man, to try to get to places. There's not enough help out there. If anybody knows, we'll take any plumber that we can get. I don't mean that in a way of we'll take any plumber we can get. What I mean is, if you are a good plumber and you are looking, we would hire you in a heartbeat, but so are the other 100 plumbing companies here in the Omaha area. They'd all take you. So you're in demand right now if you're a licensed plumber. For that fact, heck, if you're in the construction world, you're probably in demand right now. So anyway, we're going to head down to this job here. It's about a half hour away from where we're at. So I don't know if I'll be able to video when I get down there. I'll ask this guy, but you know, some people don't want you to. It is a fire job, so insurance is involved. They may not want us to video. If not, we'll kind of go over the job with you when we're done. All right. So hey guys, we're driving down to this job site to meet this new contractor. Anyway, I got a little bit of time, thought maybe there's a couple topics that I'd like to discuss. And I just kind of wanted to go, I guess, a little bit more into depth about what I was saying about working with different contractors. One of the biggest mistakes that you can do as a subcontractor, okay, is partner yourself with contractors that aren't good at their jobs, okay? What I mean by that is I'm not being arrogant, okay? What I'm saying is, if you're good at what you do, you show up on time, you take care of your work, you do good quality workmanship, you charge a fair price, you get your paperwork, your invoices in on time, all that. I expect that also of my contractors, okay? I've had contractors that will set up meetings for, and they're always late. Now, when I say that, don't get me wrong, guys. Everybody runs 5-10 minutes late every now and then. All I expect is a phone call, okay? If I'm running late to a job, I don't care if it's 5-10 minutes. I'll call that contractor and let them know, hey, I hit traffic. Hey, I got caught up on my last job. You know, my inspector took longer than I thought. A phone call is all it takes sometimes. Now, me, I have to be at this job in 45, or in at 10:15. It's about a 25-minute drive-ish, give or take, where I'm at. I'm leaving 45, 50 minutes early to make sure I allow myself time to get there. I'd rather get there 15 minutes early and sit in my truck and look at emails, return phone calls if I have to, than be late, all right? It just shows respect to be on time. You know, another thing is just quality of craftsmanship. You got to remember, I'm the subcontractor. So let's say I'm working for, Bob's Construction Company. I'm just throwing out a name there. Bob's the one who meets the customer. They're the ones who sell the job. They're the ones who are running everything. I'm just a subcontractor, okay? First of all, I respect my contractors. They don't have to hire me. There's a lot of plumbers they could hire. So I do respect them. It's their customer. But at the same time, if that contractor is bad at their job, meaning, you know, the parts they're doing, their coordination of scheduling subs, the work that they're responsible for is so bad, you're going to have mad customers. Well, all that customer knows is Jeff Mum Plumbing works with these guys. They must be bad too. So every job, not every job is perfect, okay? There's glitches, man, on every job. When you're doing construction, especially high-end construction like we get into, 100-year-old houses, people are spending, you know, $100,000 on bathroom remodels. They expect a level of quality better than anyone else. I get that. Sometimes things go wrong. But if they continually go wrong, you got to ask yourself, do I want to be part of this contractor's workforce? The answer is no, you don't. I know that's tough. You know, you're scared of not getting work. Trust me, if you are good at what you do in construction, you will be busy for a long time, all right? There's always going to be construction. Don't listen to people, well, Jeff, what about when the economy goes bad? Doesn't matter. There's still construction going on. Will it slow down? Of course. Does that happen? But if you are good what you would do, you probably won't be slow. The guys who slow down then are the ones who are bad at what they do. Well, you know, they're the first to go. They're the first to get laid off, all right? So don't, if you're good at your skill, at your trade, don't worry about finding work. It'll be out there. Don't partner yourself with bad contractors, okay? Find the good ones, pair yourselves up with them, and together you all complement each other. So anyway, just thought I'd share that. I've been in business 23 years, trust me, man. I've worked for contractors that are bad. I've worked with contractors that are great, and some in between. Just because you're a great big contractor who does millions of dollars a year in business doesn't mean you're good, okay? You still can be bad at what you do, all right? Some of the best contractors I work for, honestly, are the smaller companies where they're hands-on. You know, they run the stuff themselves. Now, there's a fine line there because sometimes the very small contractors, they may do the job well, but they struggle at scheduling work. They struggle at the paperwork side of it, the office side of it. That all is part of running a business. So anyway, that's just my thoughts on the matter. Of course, every job's different, but take it from somebody who has a lot of experience. Be careful who you work with out there. Find the good ones, pair yourselves with them. The bad ones, hit the road. So, all right, we're out. All right, so we're here on this new fire job. Got a bathroom sink, toilet, a one-piece tub and shower unit up here. Got a hand sprayer attachment here. You look under the sink. Tell the sink is vented. So those are things we need to make notes on. Come in this. Yeah, looks like there was a washer hookup maybe. I'm not really sure here if they had a washer dryer sitting here. They got this floor drain where the furnace goes. Okay, no other bathrooms up here. Alright, so this is the top level of the house. So I need to make some notes. I'm just going to try to get a video here first of everything. Coming down to the main level. So there was a kitchen sink there, gas stove there. We're not dealing with any of the gas work. This here was a bathroom. So there was obviously a bathtub right there, toilet there. Must have been a sink here somewhere. All right, so there was where the sink was. Obviously the house is gutted already. You come down here, you can see where the fire was. And you see all the drywall, it's been ripped down probably from firemen. You can come down here and look. See the PVC pipes are just melted. So this is that bathroom on the main level above us. This here goes to the bathroom sink on the main level next to the kitchen. See, this plumbing's all been damaged by the fire, so it'll all get replaced. We got this pipe here that runs over. This eventually goes upstairs, this main drain here to the master bathroom upstairs. That was the first bathroom I showed you. You can see here, that's what a fire does. This here's obviously the room where the fire started. I don't know exactly what caused it, so maybe with the furnace or electrical.
Got water pipes coming in. There's your main water line. So we came down here and winterized this house a few days ago. That means we took our air compressor and blew out all the water pipes, trying to save what we could. This is a bathroom that was down here in the basement. So this will have to all get gutted. Got this water heater here. You can tell it's been damaged by the fire. Electric 65 gallon water heater. So basically, what we'll need to do is, and I'll go over this with you later. So this is the garage. So that 3-inch pipe goes up. So all this plumbing goes to that master bathroom on the top level of the house. All that's installed illegally, T's on the side, stuff's not vented properly, so it's all gonna have to get replaced as part of code update. That up there went to the bathtub on the top level, not vented. Not done correctly, that's all gotta get changed. So anyway, I'll go through now and make all my notes, take measurements, take pictures, and I'll have to get the contractor a bid, and I'll go over a little bit more of these fire jobs. They're interesting how they work with city requirements and all that. I also forgot I have a water softener there that will have to be replaced. So anyway, just kind of wanted to show you what the fire looks like on the inside of the house, and we'll go over this one in more detail at a later date. All right, we're out.